There are so many different movements in every workout, but which ones are the most effective in order to activate the deep muscles and create the fastest fat burning process?
Hello Daily Student family, welcome back to another video. Now, as you guys can tell from the title of today's video, I'm going to be talking about thigh exercises. Not just any thigh exercises. A lot of the time it's known that we only actually use 30% to 35% effective movements in our workouts, and when it comes down to thigh slimming, like I did with my journey, I wanted you guys to know which exercises and specifically which movements are so important for activating the areas you want to create an effective fat burning process. When I'm doing a workout and knowing that, you know, some exercises are just genuinely not activating where I want to, not effective, not doing very much, I'm a bit like, So imagine having all those exercises into one and having those noted down of what are really effective to get activated in your thigh burning process. So for that, I've took to my knowledge from personal training, CrossFitters, everything like that, all throughout my journey, which movements are really effective to stick to and to do, and which videos they feature in here on YouTube to create a little library for yourself of which videos are really effective to go for. Now, first exercise is this one. It looks crazy and it feels it when you first do it for the very first time, but it's also important that if you see this exercise in a workout, and yes, it can feel a bit awkward and difficult at times, but you want the burn. You want it to feel awkward. You want it to feel hard because it's working. The reason why this one's so good, and I read a full description on how effective this one actually is it actually is because it runs all the way down inner thigh as well as targeting a lot of the outer thigh as well. By the third one, I promise you it'll be burning. Usually for me, it's by the 8th, 9th, 10th one. By the third one, you should feel a heavy burn. And for this, your posture and placement of the movement is so crucial and important. I think it was in the Blogilates video, she really explained how putting your body in the right position for this movement is so important. The reason why I explained to you this is because rather than doing a 10-minute workout that has some movements that are effective, some that are not, some that are really basic, this one is more of a high advanced level movement in itself, high advanced level movement in itself that is burning and pushing the muscles so effectively for that burn specifically. And when you look at muscle placements within the movements, that's why they end up being a lot really effective. The videos that this features in is the Blogger Lattes video, which is this one, but also in the Lily Sabri video. So if you ever come across a workout video and see this movement, you're going to want to isolate it. To advance even more, what you can do is 4 or 5 minutes on top of your workout, or even as opposed to your normal home workout on YouTube, isolate these movements and try and do it in repetitions and increase and increase and increase this movement. So you might do this movement for 3 minutes, have a rest. Do it for 4 whole minutes and have a rest. So building up like that, because you know it's just hitting the nail on the head in terms of the complexity and the effectivity of the movement. It's ranked one of the highest, most effective movements for inner and outer thigh burning. The next movement is possibly a lot of our arch nemesis, and that is the sumo squat. Now, this one can feel so easy at first because you're going down really quickly, it's really effective, it's really easy, you're having fun, but actually what you really want to do is isolate this movement, because not only does it burn the inner thighs, it's actually, again, one of the most effective movements for inner thigh burn and fat burn altogether. What you really want to do to achieve the optimum amount of effectivity with this movement is have a really flat surface and try to get as low as you can. Then, I know we do them really quickly and a really speeded amount of time, but you're going to want to slow this movement right down and go down slowly on counts of 5, up on counts of 5. And that is when you'll actually start to feel the burn and you're really working and pushing the muscles at this point. So again, videos that feature the sumo squat is going to be a video like this one by Mad Fit. It's just so good and such a good burn. And again, like I say, it's one of the most effective thigh burning workouts because it targets the inner and outer thigh, as well as a little bit of the calves. The next movement, I don't actually see in a lot of thigh workout videos. As you guys know, I've tried so many, but this movement doesn't tend to get repeated a lot when it's one of the most important movements. I remember at CrossFit classes, we would use this movement so much and it burns like crazy, but when you look at the women there at CrossFit, their legs are just so toned and slender. This movement's actually absolutely fantastic. And again, going into so many different workouts, this one is ranked, again, one of the most effective and good for muscle fat burning. It's going to really pull your inner and outer thigh so much, and it's going to burn like crazy. If it doesn't burn by the fourth one, guys, you're going to want to slow that right down. When you're doing the movement, slow it right down and let your body weight carry your legs, because you really want to be burning those muscles, burning and pushing everything. Again, if you isolate this and do this in repetition, so maybe you do this for 2 minutes, have a rest. Do it for 3 minutes, have a rest, and do that in a set of 10 minutes or 8 minutes, you're going to feel the burn. You know, when the next day you find it hard to walk up the stairs or to sit down in the car or to sit down on a seat, this is the type of movements that gets you that, and that's when you know it's giving you the right burn and it's really, really working. So you're gonna wanna do that, and it features in this video. I absolutely loved, actually, most of the movements in this video are fantastic because they're such good thigh activators, which again, I don't see in all the videos that I watch. They'll have some good movements, but some of them are like, you could have a better movement in that replacement. The next movement I actually saw in an Emmy Wong video. Now, it doesn't surprise me. I've always thought Emmy Wong actually features movements that tend to be neglected in a lot of other workouts. Now, this one is actually really interesting because you guys tell me that sometimes you do your ab workouts or your thigh workouts in bed. I was like, huh? But then reading the title of this video, and I have done this video before, but I just never had read the full title. It's actually a thigh in bed thigh workout. And this movement actually is fantastic because, like, she shows that you can do it in bed, but also it's really important because you're using body weight but also doing a thigh workout. And when you use the two together, not only are you actually getting your core, which means your waist and your stomach, and snatching that in one workout, you're also doing your arm because you're leaning and using your body weight to keep you up, so you're testing your arm muscles. But also, main focus, you're using so much of your legs and your leg muscles to target that inner and partially your outer thigh as well. So I thought this one's absolutely fantastic, and again, this is one of the highest ranked thigh effectivity muscles to really get that thigh process and fat burning process going. So use this one, do it in your own set, use all the movements I've mentioned in this video and kind of create your own little repetition and set of, you know, 2 minutes on, 1 minute rest, 2 minutes on again, 1 minute rest, 2 minutes on again, 1 minute rest. Do it in a YouTube advert. I mean, I used to do it in TV adverts, but I don't really watch TV anymore. I'm more of a YouTube gal or a podcast gal. So again, do it in the adverts, do it in the ad breaks, and do your sets and repetitions, because you know, once you know you've got the holy grail of effective movements, just run with it. You'd rather run with that and do all you can to try and get the best results possible than have the easy to medium easy movements that kind of get there, kind of not, but also, last but not least, really, really work on your posture. One rule of thumb that we always use in CrossFit is, for someone who does it with the right posture, only has to do 5. Someone who does it with the wrong posture has to do 35 to get the same effectivity of the same exact movement. So really, really work on your posture. Use these movements to drive your posture, drive everything to really, really help you get best results possible. Now, guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video, that it has actually helped you on what you need to focus on, what's really, really important, because when training in CrossFit, we use movements and how effective they are as the core of results. And you've seen CrossFitters, they're really, really fit, they're really, really good, because they really use that utilizing. It's not just a routine, it's about how effective is that actual movement. And that's why I really wanted to show you guys and drive for you guys today. Now, guys, if you want to see more of these, I have so many other movements that are really, really good and really, really hard. And if you want me to give you those, give this video a massive thumbs up. Don't forget to come over and follow my podcast page, turn your bell notifications on so you get notified every single time they upload. Give this video a massive thumbs up. Love you guys so much. I'll see you guys very, very soon. Bye, guys.